Hello, my name is Lisa Caulley, and I'm one of the editorial fellows at the New England Journal of Medicine. Today, we'll be discussing a new review article series entitled The Frontiers in Medicine that showcases the ways in which new technology is influencing medicine. Over the last year, the New England Journal of Medicine editorial team has been working with leading experts to prepare the series that presents the translation of scientific knowledge into new devices, drugs, and techniques that can improve patient care. To introduce the series, we have Dr. Elizabeth Phimister, who's one of the deputy editors and one of the editorial leads for the Frontiers in Medicine series. Dr. Phimister, can you tell us a bit about this series and what readers can expect?
Absolutely. So the journal publishes manuscripts covering a very broad arc of focus, from understanding the mechanisms of disease, for example, the genetic causes of disease, right through to phase three trials of new interventions to treat disease. And the series also follows that same arc. So at the one on the one end of the spectrum, in the science space, we have an article on the extracellular vesicle, which is an area of intense interest and growth right now. I think it was only 6 years ago that the International Society of Extracellular Vesicles initiated. Another article in the science space is an article on mapping neurologic and psychiatric symptoms to networks of neurons in the brain, knowledge of which might one day be used to identify new targets for treatment. At the other end of the spectrum is an article on oligonucleotide drugs, which are a new form, a relatively new form of drug. I think particularly exciting because it targets protein expression at the level of messenger RNA. So it can target messenger RNA for degradation and decrease of expression of the protein, or it can tweak splicing to ramp up expression of the protein. Also in the clinical end of the spectrum is an article on the use of circulating cell-free DNA to screen for fetal trisomies. This method has been rapidly embraced in the last 5 years and now is the screen of choice in many countries.
So why did the journal think this topic was important?
Well, we know that our readers are interested not only in learning about new and better ways to treat their patients, but also the translational research, the science that generated these new drugs and new devices, new methods to treat disease in the first place.
As a surgeon, I really appreciate the advances that we've seen in minimally invasive approaches to surgery. What excited you about the series?
Everything. I'm a technophile. I handle genetics and genomics research reports for the journal. I handle ophthalmology manuscripts. And just taking the field of ophthalmology and looking back over the past 20 years, one can see how different technologies, approaches have really impacted the field. DNA sequencing has led to the identification of many disease genes that, when variant, cause congenital forms of blindness and also vision loss. They've also made it possible to generate animal models of disease, which in turn has made it possible to develop gene therapy approaches to treating disease. More recently, new ways to image the retinal vasculature has led to the design of new types of clinical trial. And of course, one can't forget the extraordinary impact that the development of antibody-based drugs to target angiogenesis has had on prevalent forms of blindness, such as age-related macular degeneration. So it is really the technology side of the series that excites me. The fact that each article provides a foundation, a clear explanation of mechanism, and also there's some looking to the future as well.
And this series really is intended for anyone who has an interest in technology, how it works, and what it can do. It was really important to us to make sure that the series was accessible to all readers. Each article is accompanied by an interview with the authors, as well as an illustrated glossary to explain specialized and uncommon terms. I'd like to thank Dr. Phimister, as well as our viewers. We hope you've enjoyed this brief introduction into the Frontiers in Medicine series. Please find the inaugural article and the accompanying editorial at NEJM.org.